Again, Sensei.
It is 12 o'clock.
Okay, here we go. All right. Get your belt, put it in your right hand. And Kia, move. Take a moment. Try and forget about all the craziness that's going on around us. And tie on your belts. Has anyone done the warm-up video so far? Keep your hand up if you've done the warm-up video with the
box. Marcus did.
Would you classify that as easy, challenging, or hard? So you can go like, so we can see like easy, challenging, hard.
Trying to unmute you, Marcus. I can't.
All right. Yeah.
Okay.
Me, I find it kind of middle ground.
You said middle ground?
Yes.
Okay. We still need like a ton of people to turn on their video. Caden, I know Bennett's working on it. There you go, Annika. Sensei Trish, Sensei Jesse.
Take your arm.
What's that? I don't know.
Bounce. Just from,
I like to take from the home.
Some of you are working from home and doing that. I'm not used to that many hours without going out and digging a hole or digging a trench or mowing the lawn. Okay, left leg in, hands are up. So this is your warm-up routine on the video. This is your jab, then this is your jab, cross, jab, cross, jab, cross, and then we added the hook to it, so it's jab, cross, hook, and again, jab, cross, hook, jab, cross, hook, and then we added the uppercut, so it's jab, cross, hook, and then uppercut all the way up the middle, jab, cross, hook, duck down, and then uppercut right down the middle. Okay, so that's in a horse stance. Since I've got the advanced kids, we should be able to keep up with the adults here. So we're going to start off with some punches. We'll throw, bend your legs. We'll throw a dozen of these. Ready? One, two, three, four, five, six. Do double punches. So each time I count, double punch. Ready? One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Good. Three punches. But now we're going to go head, middle, low. Head, middle, low. Ready? Key eye on punch number three. Go. Hey. Okay, now we're going to do five. High, middle, low, middle, high. So you're going to finish off at the top where you started. So it's high, middle, low, middle, high. Ready? I'm going to switch to the same hand. Ready? Key on punch number five. Sit in your stance and go. One, two, three, four. Hey. bring it across your chest and punch underneath with the other hand. So this is still up on your chest. Then pull that hand back and hammer fist to the side of the head. Coming wham to the side. This should finish in front of your head. Again, starting with the other hand. Punch, pull it across your body, punch underneath. Pull this hand back as you strike to the side of the head. So again, punch head, come across your body. Punch underneath, pull that back as you strike to the side of the head in front of you. Ready? High, middle, high. Switch sides. High, middle, high. Keep those legs bent. Ready? Head, body, head. Again, head, body, head. Ready? Go. Left, right, left. Go. One, two, three. Go. One, two, three. That big smile on Nadia's face is because she's completely lost. Ready? Go. One, pull it over. Two, hit. And one, pull it over. Three. One, pull it over. Three. One, pull it over. Three. Good. Okay. And then let's put your right leg back. I'm going to slide all the way back here. Start with fighting stance. We're going to do a front kick. Step in to a horse stance from there. Ready? Hands are in a fighting stance. Kick, step into your horse stance. Key eye when you land in your horse. Move. This time, add the elbow to the head. So kick, step into your horse stance, bring that forward arm behind you, and then we're striking with an elbow to the head. And then step back to your fighting stance. So kick, step in, elbow, key on the elbow. Ready? One. As soon as you finish the elbow strike, come straight back to your fighting position. Ready? Four. Five. Six. Sit down or stand. Seven. Those legs. Nine. Bend those legs. Last one. Ten. And so that you don't walk funny all day, jump and switch. Ten on the other side. Ready. One. Kick. Elbow. Step back. Two. If you're at home going, this is super easy, bend, kick higher, elbow harder, get in a deeper horse stance. One more. Not nine, no. Four, ready? Four. Kick. Way down here. And back. Five. Seven. Eight. Nine. Ten. Good. Okay. So since we're on a limited time format, we're going to stick with those as your warm-up basic kick punches. And now switch to kata, bottom form one, two, pinyon one, pinyon two, opinion on three. And then we'll take one request from the student gallery there. Ready? And walking form number one. We're going that way. Ready? Bow. Step into your horse. Look at your legs on the video. Sit way down. Ready? Pop! The same way as you guys. I'm not a huge fan of the mirror on some of this stuff. I'd rather do it with the person facing the same way as me. So we're going to turn around and do blocking form two. Bop. Step out. Pull.
Set.
Leg one.
Set.
Two.
Set.
Three.
Set.
Step back. Four.
Set.
Out. Five.
Set.
Over your head.
Hey.
Twist seven.
Hey.
Hey. Pull.
Hey.
And wow. Okay, we're on pinion number one. If you need to shorten your stances, that's fine. You don't have to do it JKA with the long, long front stances. So we're going to shorten. Just because we've got a smaller space. Ready? Again, we're facing away from you guys, so we're all going to follow along. Bob. Salutation. Now, go back to your calf stance. If there's one thing that's frequently missed, it's this calf stance. When you transition from your opening salutation and you draw back, make sure both arms are crossed. Step out wide so that you're in a good front stance. Then snap down your block, step forwards. Yeah. And snap. Second attacker, go. Cross behind, snap out your block, step in. Yeah. Nadia's wondering if I'm going to punch her in the back of the head. You don't have to worry. It's always going to be a yes. So shorten your stance. Shorten your stance so that you can get a good punch. So just as a technical thing, if you don't have the room and the space, if Nadia is a bad guy, and I'm going to use the wall here, if Nadia is a bad guy and I have to punch, I'm not going to do this, right, and shorten my punch. What I'm going to do is adjust my stance. So if she had thrown a punch with her left, with her hand, which I block, if I'm going to punch her, I'm not going to go, hey, and stop that punch here. I'm going to readjust my feet. So I can get a good strong punch. So readjust your feet. They're a means to an end, not an end in themselves. So when you're shortened up for space, if I only had 3 feet of space here between me and my attacker, I'm still going to get a good stance, good powerful punch as I move and strike. So that's the end of number two. Left hand, left leg. Attacker three, draw back, same thing, don't miss your calf stances, block. Three punches, go. One, two,
hey!
Close that hand, good. Attacker four, cross all the way behind, don't forget to counterbalance your movement, block. Step in and punch. Remember, adjust your stance so you can get a good strong punch. Attacker five, block, step through, punch. Draw back, coming down. Make sure you're in a good front stance as you snap out on your block. Step through one, step through two, step in three. Left hand comes up, cross. Four. Again, I've run out of space here, so I'm going to adjust so I can get a good position. That's seven. This is eight. Block, step through punch, step back, front, and bow. Okay, now this is where it's really important that you have a training partner. Now you can get some water, please.
Hey, Professor. Professor, yes. I just want you to notice Emily's new setup at her house. I have to spotlight this. Look at that.
That is very nice.
That is awesome.
Emily, when'd you get that?
Drop down projection TV system. I've seen that at parties.
Yeah, it's experimental. We've had it for a while, but it just using it for this is experimental. It's all backwards right now. And I keep walking in front of the projector. So it's kind of,
It looks pretty awesome though.
We're working on
it. Yeah, it looks awesome.
Thanks.
Cool. I want one. Okay. So we'll quickly do two, quickly do three, hit some self-defense. Let me call it there. So, Nadia, that's all you get for a water break. Get up. Let's go. So, we're on pinion two. Bow. Step out. Bend those legs. Salutation. Roar back. Step out. Hard walk. High punch. Walk. High punch. Remember, adjust your stance, adjust your material so that you can punch at head height and not have to lean back and do all sorts of crazy stuff like this. Get in a good stance. Tacker three with the high blocks. Go. Yeah. One, step in. Two, step in. Three. This is the only tricky piece for a lot of people. Turn, hammer block with that left arm. Get in a good stance. Make sure you keep your hands tight in elbow position. Hammer block. Hammer strike, Kenpo punch, step in, front punch. From there, turn, hammer block, hammer strike, Kenpo punch, front punch. Look, same cat stance when you come down the center here. Step, block.
Yeah, you don't get to submit anything until you.
High five. Dip into your horse stance. High five. If you want to hit this on the way through, that's fine. Then block. Make sure you elbow this hand behind your back. Make sure it's on the side. Step in. High five. Again, if you want to hit that hand, that's fine. Block. Step into your last four stance. High five. Punch. And this is where you get to cheat on your footwork, which is perfect for being in your living room. Just turn. Outward block. Good stance. Kenpo punch low. Uppercut. This hand clears everything in front of your face. And then tiger's mouth. Adjust your footwork. Turn block. Kenpo punch down. Uppercut punch up. And then clear everything in front of you. Tiger's mouth. Make sure that other hand's up in front of your chest. Look to the front, step out. And there's number two. Number next is number three. So facing the same way. Bow, step out. Side take. I'm gonna bar you here in a second. Go back to your cat stance. Step out, block, knife hand block, step in, Kenpo punch. So I heard questions on this when I was walking you guys last week. I think the question was, is the punch in front of you? Is it an angle? Where's your opponent? So the answer to that is my opponent is in front of me and she's throwing one punch, which I block down here. Then she throws a second punch, which I block out of the way there. But if I move straight in, I end up way inside my social distancing regulations. So I've done my first block. There's my second block. I step in. I'm slightly to the side, which means her belly, her target is now on an angle just to the side here. Okay? So your opponent is staying in the same position. just moving slightly around them. So let's say she kicks this time. Bam! Then she punches. Bam! I step in, but because of my position, she's on an angle so that when I punch, it looks like I'm punching someone else on the side, but I'm not. Same person right there. Okay? So that's your angling reasons for your first couple of attackers. Attacker two, same deal. Turn, down block, second block, step in, Kenpo punch. Third attacker, draw back, step out, hammer block, knife hand block. Step all the way in, Kenpo punch to the face. So this would be, don't move, this would be here. And then my low strike is gonna circle. Remember, this one's up in front of me as a guard. Boom, there's my first one. I'm gonna come around that one and then strike down. So it's one, make a circle, two, one, two. Then if she were to punch, I would block this again. Nice punch. That's they've been laying on the couch too many hours. Punch, block, step in, one, and then her arm's in the way here. So I'm bringing my hand in so I can come in and around and strike down low. So that's why you have the stances. That's why you have that circle movement coming around your hand. So we are on number one. We just did a block, block, step in, high, low. Second one, block, step in, high, low. Third one, block, step in, high, low. Turn for attacker four, hammer block, knife in, step in. Same reasoning as the first two attackers. This is going to be angle. Punch. Nice punch. Turn. Hammer block. Bam. Knife in. Step in. Power. Uppercut. Draw back. Step out to your front stance. Hammer block. Step in. And this is where kids say all those funny things. What are they, Nadia?
Up, up, down, up, left.
She forgot, which is why I repeat them every class. Up, up, down, up. Right, left, right, left, block, block, punch, punch, one, two, three, four. I hope you're not just standing there watching me do all these. Please do them with me. I don't want to be the only person in a ball of sweat here. Up, up, down, up. Again, high block, Kenpo punch, uppercut. One time. Up. Up, down, up. Step in. The forward leg is doing your movements here. Up, up, down, up. Third one, step in. One, two, three, four. What I tell the kids here is, this is like the boss on your video games. This guy throws three punches at you. So turn, block the first one. Bam, block the second one. Step in and block the third one. And then bring this back. That's your corkscrew punch, the block, punch and cover. If you can, I want to hear that gi pop as you do that punch. Turn, hammer block, knife hand block. Step in. This is your last attacker. Block, punch and cover. You're done. Step back. Front and bow. Nice.
Professor?
Yes.
Marcus has his hand raised.
He should be punching already. He shouldn't still be up yet.
So I have a question on number three. And I may be misremembering the way I learned it. But I don't know if you can see me, but excuse me. Can you
hang on, I'll spotlight you, Marcus.
Okay. When you come down and do your knife hand block, the way I remember learning it, and I may not be remembering this correctly, I remember landing the punch here and then dropping the hammer as we move forward. But the way you were doing it was here, you're coming into the fighting stance here and then drop the reverse hammer. So did I learn incorrectly? Or maybe misremembering the way I was taught? Or has it changed?
Those are all teaching methods by the instructor.
Okay. If you
any of the MMA stuff, then they don't do this. They do this. So all of those transitions are designed to give you the basic footwork and the basic handwork. But if I was actually don't go anywhere, Nadia, otherwise you'll die. So from here, as I'm coming in on my opponent, she may have thrown her punch. Now you can move, throw the punch. She may have thrown that punch, and I'm going to block it, okay? But then my movement and my footwork is my body coming in towards her so that I get momentum and weight, and then my two strikes. But you have to break it down to teach it. So there's my block, but my movement should be like lightning because you guys are all ninjas. So it should be super fast, but you can't teach that to a beginning student when they're first learning the movement. So it's got to be broken down. So if Nadia punches, I go block, bam! She punches again. She's like, I don't want to punch again. She punches again. One, two. So the transition and the footwork are going to change as you move faster through the technique. When you go slowly, I teach it. One, two, step in, three, four, clear. Step in, one, two. But at actual kata speed, the transitions are going to get squeezed together. And it's going to be like what you did the first time there with the movement. Bam! In and down. It's going to be very fast.
Thank you.
Add some clarity. It may just be adding mud to the equation.
No, it's fine. I just want to make sure I'm doing it correctly. Thank you.
All right. Nadia, what are you doing? So, Sensei, what do we got? 2 minutes?
You are at, 2 minutes. Sorry. That okay. Went by fast.
If you haven't seen the video that we filmed yesterday for the this week's karate challenge, the adults can do this too. I'm going to let Nadia do it a second time here. So it's roundhouse kicks in, and I just want to clarify this, 30 seconds, especially for us old guys, 30 seconds. If you want to do it for a minute, that's great. Just take your number and divide by two, and that will give you your score for 30 seconds. So this is your technique. Good horse stance, hands up. And from there, she moves back and blocks. She swings the arm down. She rips to the face. And then, pow, there's the roundhouse kick. So to practice this at home, or if you've got your kids, then you're going to be throwing your roundhouse kick into the pad. Go, Nadia. Boom. So she's stopping and stepping down. Keep going. She's stopping. And, keep going. Okay, so she's going to end up with maybe, I don't know, 120 kicks in 30 seconds. Pow, pow. Could happen. Okay, if you've got the balance for it, hold that. Okay. If you've got the balance, then you can just stand here, throw your leg up from there. One, two, three, four, five, six. Pow, and go all the way through for 30 seconds, and you should be able to get about 45 or 50 kicks. You may have to do it in slow motion to count them all. They're going to be so fast. You can put that back on the camera. Okay, so that gets us through some kata. We reviewed grabs and weapons. Any special requests for the last couple minutes?
Well, mention private lessons, Professor. It's 12:30.
So for every week of class that the dojo is closed, we're offering our members a 15-minute private lesson with one of our instructors. That's for everyone. It's not just kids. It's adults, it's everybody. We've got, I think, 6 or 7 of our instructors, myself, Shihan Roland, Shihan Mike, Sensei Callan, Sensei Corey, Sensei Genevieve, Sensei Adam, several of the instructors. And all we do is go to the page on streaming that we have set up and click on private lessons, and it'll take you to the scheduler. Some of the days are blocked out, some of the times are blocked out for different instructors. So if you can't find the time and day that you want, just switch instructors, just click on their picture, and that'll put you through to the scheduler. And then let's say you wanted a class tomorrow at 3, you click on the instructor, it'll bring up the schedule, and if it's open, you can click in there and schedule your 15-minute session. So if you have specifics that you want to clarify, if you have something that you're learning in class that is separate from the regular group workout, if you're specifically working on combat bow, or you're working on your punch defenses and need some one-on-one time, this specifically is what that's set up for. So go on, schedule. I hope to see some of you guys It's a nice opportunity. I don't usually teach the lunchtime adult class, so it's a lot of fun for Sensei Kellen to let me teach you guys. And if you want to do some privates, do a private lesson with Sensei Kellen. Do a private lesson with Shihan Mike. Take one with me. And it should be a lot of fun. So I'm looking forward to that.
Also, Professor, I believe Shihan Mike said he would teach this class on Wednesday.
Excellent.
Yeah.
Excellent. I'm going to stay in my pajamas then. Very good. So there'll be several new classes being added. We're going to film some more warm-up classes. I'm going to do a range of motion and cool down. We've got a moment, but we're going to do an abs class and a planking class. And Sensei Tom has got a fitness workout that he's working on. So does Sensei Jimmy. I talked to them yesterday. So those are a lot of fun. I think I'm trying to talk Sensei Jimmy into doing his fitness class on Saturday morning from his home. And then Phil and Sensei Gina and all those guys can come in and work out, which I think would be fun. Any more?
I think we're good, Professor. That's time.
Okay. Well, thank you all for coming in and joining us. Sensei Kellen, thank you for your lunch class. That was a lot of fun.
Thanks for doing it.
Come visit us. Watch some more of the streaming classes. Friends involved. If you have people that have never trained and that are stuck at home, we're going to start a beginner's group class, which will take you right from the start. How to roll your hands into a fist. What is it? How to punch, how to counterbalance your strikes. It'll be from day one. It's just a beginner's class for new students coming in, because I know a lot of people are stuck at home. They got nothing to do. They're tired of watching the P90X videos because they're not interactive. So this we can do either on the private classes, if you have a friend that wants to come in, or the group class, either way. So group classes, private lessons, should be fun. Okay, thank you very much. We'll bow out. Okay, bow. Good dojo. Nice. Hands come up. Step out. Ready? Move.
Hey.
And belts.
Nice. Maybe we could see if we could get a private lesson with Sensei Shane on that.
Nice job, helper. See you guys next class.